Morning, everyone. We have this coming Saturday the Hull Culture Train concert in church. It's 7:40, 7:30. It's what's called acoustic music. I can't imagine any music that isn't acoustic. But if it's your thing, you'll know what it is and you'll be very welcome. We had one the year before lockdown, and I must admit, I quite enjoyed it. Is there anybody who wants to make any other notice? Nothing else? Nothing I've forgotten? Sorry? Am I not turned on? Thank you. I was unmuted, but not turned on. Which is just as well, because I was singing the hymn. In case you didn't hear, yes, next Saturday we have the Hull Culture Train concert here at 7:40, 7:30. It is what's called acoustic music. If it's your sort of thing, you'll know what that is. I quite enjoyed it last year. That's for those who didn't hear. So on our service sheets, grace, mercy and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And also with you.
We say together, Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, the first commandment is this: Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is the only Lord. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this: Love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbor in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past and grant that we may serve you in newness of life to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who in Jesus Christ has given us a kingdom that cannot be destroyed, forgive you your sins, open your eyes to his truth, strengthen you to do his will, and show you the joy of his kingdom. Amen. And we'll say the glory together. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. And the Collect. O God, you declare your mighty most chiefly in showing mercy and pity, mercifully grant to us such a measure of your grace, that we, running the way of your commandments, may receive your gracious promises, and be made partakers of your heavenly treasure, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. And I'm afraid that was the wrong comment, so we'll have the right one. Almighty and everlasting God, you are always more ready to hear than we to pray, and to give more than either we desire or deserve. Pour down upon us the abundance of your mercy, forgiving us those things of which our conscience is afraid, and giving us those good things which we are not worthy to ask, but through the merits and mediation of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And we'll have our Old Testament reading.
Our first reading is a reading from the book of the Song of Solomon. The voice of my beloved, look, he comes, leaping upon the mountains, bounding over the hills. My beloved is like a gazelle or a young stag. Look, there he stands behind our wall, gazing in at the windows, looking through the lattice. My beloved speaks and says to me, arise, my love, my fair one, and come away. For now the winter is past, the rain is over and gone. Flowers appear on the earth. The time of singing has come, and the voice of the turtle dove is heard in our land. The fig tree puts forth its figs, and its vines are in blossom. They give forth fragrance. Arise, my love, my fair one, and come away. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you, God. Our gradual hymn is number 14, All Heaven Declares. They do not eat anything scribes asked him, "Why do your disciples not live according to the traditions of the elders, but eat with defiled hands?" He said to them, "Isaiah prophesied rightly about you, hypocrites, as it is written, 'This people honors me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me. In vain do they worship me, teaching human precepts as doctrines. You abandon the commandment of God and hold to human tradition.'" This is the gospel of the Lord. Please sit down. I'm afraid while I was reading this, something came into my mind, and it was what a brave person Jesus was saying to the scribes and the Pharisees, "You hypocrites." And if you, I'm sure you are, well old enough to remember Fawlty Towers, yes? At one point, Basil refers to Sybil as his little nest of vipers. Well, Jesus also called the Pharisees a nest of vipers. Sometimes, well, most of the time, you can't do better than the Bible, and even Shakespeare is a very poor second to it. But today, we have the Pharisees complaining that the disciples were eating without washing their hands. Now, we are not talking here about washing your hands for reasons of health and cleanliness. I don't doubt that when that law was written, part of the reason was health. But that is not why the Pharisees are objecting. They are objecting because it is something that the religion demanded that people did, and the disciples are not doing it. It was ritual washing rather than hygiene washing. Everything to do with tradition. And Jesus, of course, points out in no uncertain terms that it is human tradition, nothing to do with hygiene, and nothing to do, more importantly, with God. "You hypocrites," he says. There's a similar incident in Matthew's Gospel, in chapter 12, where it says, "At that time, Jesus went through the cornfields on the Sabbath. His disciples were hungry, and they began to pluck heads of grain and to eat. When the Pharisees saw it, they said, 'Look, your disciples are doing what it is not lawful to do on the Sabbath.'" And very similarly, Jesus points out that they are wrong. As quite often happens, I have an element of sympathy with the Pharisees. They are clinging desperately to their security, and their security is in the law. In many ways, they were well enough meaning. In other ways, they had the same faults as you and I. They wanted their security. That's where it lay. It was an emotional security for them. It also kept their lifestyle intact, so it was important. There's also underlying it the straightforward matter that we all like the familiar. Familiarity gives us that feeling of security, whether it's real security or not. The familiar things around us do the same. The trouble is that in the context of Christianity, we are called, this is particularly Anglican, we are called to proclaim the faith afresh in every generation. It's in the preface to the Declaration of Assent. It's a core aim of the Church of England. In many ways, that is because it is our role to meet the needs of everyone. And as society changes and we change and people change, we as a community have to change too. And we can't do that unless we have open minds. Minds that are open to changes in theology as new concepts and ideas emerge. I hate to say it, but much of the theology that's reflected in our hymns is from the medieval era. And yes, I'm sure you say, well, yes, but God doesn't change. True enough, he doesn't. But when you go to see the GP, do you expect him or her to treat you the way a supposed medic would have treated you in 1500? Or even 1900? Of course you don't, because understanding has developed. And in a similar way, understanding has developed where God is concerned. We need to have minds open to change in the way we worship, to include new and maybe younger people, people who are just different from us maybe. Now, this isn't to devalue older people. I did see in a document not very long ago that churches want, sorry ladies, more young people and more men. I found that quite offensive. Personally, I want in this church the people God calls to be in this church. And I don't care whether they're young, old, male, female, or have antennae on their heads. I want everyone God calls, and it's not for me to say who God is calling. We need to be open to everyone, and people that God calls, people of all types, to worship. We need changes in our other activities to make sure that we remain relevant and we show God's love to people in ways they are recognized. In many ways we are not doing too badly, you know, but I think in other ways it's costing us emotionally more than is ideal, because it's hard work keeping an open mind. It's not easy. We have to sacrifice some of the ideas and ways we're familiar with. Changes are unsettling, and sometimes we do respond badly, all of us. But you know, we can be sure that as we change, God will guide us. We just have to be awake to his promptings and be willing to take some calculated risks. And if we make mistakes, well, God will still love us, still forgive us, and continue to guide us. Amen. Let's stand for the creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, was incarnate for the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And we are fit for our prayers.
Blessed are you, Lord our God. You give us life, you give us love, you give us yourself. We come to give our lives and our love to you. Cleanse us from all our sin and make a clean heart within us, that we may do what you want us to do and be the people you want us to be. We give thanks for the examples of the saints in their battle against evil and in their striving to do good. We remember before you all who are struggling with temptation, all who are pulled by divided loyalties. We pray for those who go through the rituals but miss the reality. We ask your blessing on all who are scorned and rejected because of their relationship with Christ. Make our hearts clean, O God. Renew a right spirit within us. We give thanks for the work of the social services and all who work for the care of others. We remember before you all who are caught up in vice or degradation. We pray for all addicts that they may find help and hope. Bless all who struggle to keep standards and make a stand against the evils that are around them. Make our hearts clean, O God, renew a right spirit within us. We rejoice in our homes and in family life. We thank you, all who have given their lives in caring for us and in loving us. We ask your blessing upon our families and friends. We remember before you all who are lonely, all who feel uncared for or unwanted. We pray for all who suffer from neglect or a breakdown in relationships. Make our hearts clean, O God, renew a right spirit within us. As we rejoice in life, we remember all who feel that life is meaningless and empty. We ask your blessing on the despairing and despondent. We pray for all who are treated as unclean through illness or disability. We remember all who work to combat disease and infections. We especially pray for today Jack Gronis, Stephen Hickinbottom, Alan Burwell, Michael Race, John Groom, Sue Swales, and Nigel Wing. Make our hearts clean, O God, renew a right spirit within us. We rejoice in the fellowship of all your saints. We remember before you all our loved ones departed, giving thanks for their life and their care. We offer our hearts and minds and whole being to you, good and gracious God. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Stand up, please. Blessed are the peacemakers. They shall be called the children of God. We meet in Christ's name and we share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let's offer one another a safe sign. Our offertory hymn is number 39, As the Deer Pants for the Water. Number 39. When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again he praised him, gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance." Praise to you, Lord Jesus, dying and destroyed our death, rising and restored our life. Lord Jesus, come in glory. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favor on your people, gather us in your loving arms, and bring us with all the saints feast at your table in heaven, through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory are yours, O loving Father, for ever and ever. Amen. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share the body of Christ. Most merciful Lord, your love compels us to come in. Our hands were unclean, our hearts were unprepared. We were not fit even to eat the crumbs from under your table. But you, Lord, are the God of our salvation, and share your bread with sinners. So cleanse and feed us with the precious body and blood of your Son, that he may live in us and we in him, and that we, with the whole company of Christ, may sit and eat in your kingdom. Amen. As usual, we'll be coming for communion from the back. Father God, we give you thanks and praise that when we were still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, he declared your love, gave us grace, and opened the gate of glory. May we who share Christ's body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. We who the Spirit lights give light to the world. Keep us firm in the hope you have set before us, so we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. God of all mercy, in this Eucharist you have set aside our sins and given us your healing. Grant that we who are made whole in Christ may bring that healing to this broken world. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always. Amen. And our final hymn is number 372, O Jesus, I Have Promised. 372.